It's a one. Let's get it. Man. Come on, man. Y'all be tripping. All right, let's see. Knew there was an ambush coming. I promise you. I didn't. It's so bright I can't see. Ooh, Barry.
Wow, those geezers had quite a production going on. Ooh, you know what, Al? If we make it through this alive, I'm gonna start representing them. Yep, sell this stuff online, maybe get a reality show going, release a new single.
Good luck with that, pal.
So what do we do with this?
You find us a way out of here, okay? I'm gonna take a closer look at
this
stuff.
The door was barred from the other side. I'd have to find another way.
Like, man, we trapped, dog. Ain't no other way. I'm gonna.
Be careful, Al!
I know. Dude, hold on, what's cracking? Get this out. They giving us all kinds of shells. Giving me some more shells. Huh? I heard some footsteps. Come on, man.
I'm good. Keep your eyes open, okay?
I knew it was about to go down. Gonna do that again, are you? Ain't gonna do me like that again, are y'all? Right, let's go up. Oh my goodness, man. Hold on, hold on. Go around real quick. Turn that on.
As you regular listeners know, I tend to work through the night, but I'm not the only one. Deputies Mulligan and Thornton are taking
a heavy
couple
duty
moments off their busy schedule to join me here in the studio. Boys, how busy are you now? Deerfest is almost here, isn't it? I bet that keeps you in business.
Pretty busy, yeah.
Use this. All right.
I could see the building that had to be the Andersons' home on the other side of the field.
Yeah, that's their farm right there.
I wasn't worried about trusting
their farmhouse.
Two burned out geriatric wrecks. They had the goods.
All right, so how do I get Barry out again? I gotta whoop on some more dudes, don't I? Okay, I'm full on the batteries, huh? Can I move? Oh my goodness.
You've got to be kidding me.
Shotgun real quick and do him in. That was a headshot. All right, cool. Got it? Alright, let's go up in here. And, alright, nothing's in here but the ladder. Hold on, man. Huh.
Keith!
Yeah, it's me. Hang on.
Hey, let's go, man.
Barry. Man. Come on, bro.
I think we're gonna have to work together to open this gate out. It's pretty heavy. Hey, I think that's the farm on the other side of the field. We're almost there. This farm is a crazy place for crazy people.
We should feel right at home then.
If I was Barry, I'd have said we. Hold on.
Come on, one more gate. Let's do this thing.
Hold on, let me look around real quick, Barry. Cause I know. Something over here, man. Maybe I'm wrong. Yeah, I'm so wrong. I'm so wrong. Hey, Barry, get off my cheeks. We'll find a freaking thermos or something. Let's go in.
The lights are out. Guess we better check the fuse box.
Look at the thermos. Hold on, I ain't worried about no lights right now, man. What is that?
The power downstairs was out, but I was sure I could fix that at the fuse box.
I didn't fix that in a minute. Watch out. Let me look around. Some more goodies. Yeah, like that. Yes, sir. Watch out. Ooh, Barry, dang, get my way, man. Dude, that light is so bright. Man, let's go upstairs.
You know, this place looks kind of empty. I thought the Andersons were
I can't even see it. What's in here? Anything? Man, that light be killing. It's locked. Hold on, manuscript page. Where's that? Oh, there it is.
Again, Alice's screams rang in the stillness of the night. I saw myself run toward the cabin, flashlight in my hand. I followed my past self. I was an out-of-body observer, a time traveler in a crazy drunken dream. This was the beginning. The night Alice had disappeared, the mystery of what had happened during the missing week was about to reveal itself.
All right.
Let's get the lights on, huh? Can you hear that, Al? Music?
Of course. We need to find where it's coming from. That's the message the Andersons talked about. That's the whole reason we're here.
Lady of the Light? Oh, that's gotta be... What's her face? The crazy landlady from the town.
Cynthia Weaver.
Right. Must be. Okay.
We need to find Cynthia Weaver. We'll stay here for the night and head back to town as soon as it gets light.
Hey, Al. Lots of hours before dawn. Might as well get some rest. And by rest, I mean drunk.
Come on, Barry. This is... Yeah. What the hell?
You're a crazy bastard. I'm gonna stick by you, no matter what, ever, Al.
Sure, like a brother.
I'm a writer, goddammit.
Correct.
If I just wanted to, I could write 10 books a year.
And they beat the best books that year.
No, you couldn't.
That's right, I couldn't. But I could, because I'm a writer.
What? What do they put in this stuff? I feel like my brain is coming out of my nose. I'm gonna get the recipe off those coots and be a booze millionaire.
I just miss her, Barry. I just want her here with me.
I know, Al. I know.
You paid me that
boy. We're gonna make it okay.
They call man. I forget what they call him. Barry's pants, but he looked like he flooding. Caprice, I think that's what they call. Yeah. Nah, he don't make caprice. He just flooding. That boy preparing for a flood. Casper.
It's all right! I'm coming!
It was a crazy drunken dream, and yet it was more than that. It was the truth, a suppressed memory unearthed by the Andersons' moonshine. I was there, an out-of-body observer. This was the night Alice and I had arrived at Bright Falls, the night Alice had disappeared. I had a chance to find out what had happened. I remembered being surprised to see the cabin dark.
Alice
would have never turned the lights off. I remembered thinking, I caught a glimpse of her form underwater, sinking into the darkness. Diving after her was the last vague memory I had of that night. After that, the next thing I could remember was waking up behind the wheel of the crash car and finding the first pages of the manuscript. I couldn't find her in all that blackness. I must have thought she drowned.
Alice!
Jagger had Alice, and so she had me.
Alice!
I'd been easy prey.
Look at the cabin. Is there someone in the window?
Crazy old lady, man.
Alice?
The dark presence had touched me. She had dug her nails into my brain and used me, made me her puppet.
Dang, can I go in? That lady right there is freaky zeeky.
She must be here somewhere. Maybe upstairs in the study.
Alice!
Yes, that's where she is. You can apologize.
Alice!
You laugh at the whole thing together and put it behind you.
Alice!
She's not here. You were foolish to think so. No, she's dead. She drowned.
No, no, no!
It's your fault your wife is dead. You are guilty. All she wanted was to help you write. You killed her. Oh, hush. There's still hope. Cauldron Lake is a special place. Here, you have the power to change things. She wanted you to write. I will tell you what to do. You can write her back. The story will come true, and all will be well again.
She had Alice, and the manuscript was the ransom for her.
Aiden?
Yes. All right. I'll fix it. I'll bring her back.
I'd written for days, a week, almost a complete manuscript of a novel entitled Departure. Jagger had been my editor, whispering in my ear, making sure that the unfolding story would make her more and more powerful. I thought I was saving Alice. Even with the cobweb she put in my head, some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story, to bring a light into the cabin to release me before I could finish, to interrupt the horror story before the ending, where darkness consumed everything and everyone. Zane was weak and far away, but I had written him into the story, and his light had been enough to set me free.
It isn't here now. I'm here because it was written. I brought the light to set you free. You must hurry. We'll know I'm here. It will be back soon. It stole the skin of my barber a long time ago. She looks so old.
I had woken up, confused and groggy, my mind consumed by darkness and fear. All I could do was to escape. The week spent in the cabin had taken its toll. I was barely conscious and fading fast. It had to have cost Zane terribly, thrown him even deeper into whatever dark place he now haunted. But he had managed to weaken the dark presence, kept me safe that night.
That's right, James Joyce. It's your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
There's an end of episode four.
I did.
Previously on Alan Wake. Under the influence of the Dark Presence, I wrote a horror story that is coming true. Jagger had been my editor, making sure that the unfolding story would make her more and more powerful. Some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story.
Together we can create something absolutely wonderful. The lake,
it does something to the works of art created here. It makes them come true. My mom gave me this old light switch.
The clicker.
Alice is being kept in a dark prison. I need to find Cynthia Weaver to fix this.
It's your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
Episode 5, The Clicker.
Well, we're expecting a record crowd from the neighboring counties. Naturally, we hope to break the record set by last year's Moose Fest in our neighboring town, Watery. Ladies and gentlemen, some people have asked me, what's the big deal about Deer Fest? And I think that this sums it up. It's about friendship and community. We've got a great party coming up, but let's try to hold it in until tomorrow and get through the night in one piece, all right?
Someone will come for it when the time is right. Thomas said so. He wrote it. The key is insurance. It's my job to keep it safe. Safe in the light. What was in the light?
Hello. Hello. Hello.
All the manuscript pages were gone. The FBI agent had taken them.
I think my tongue just took a crap in my mouth. Oh, wait, we're in jail now? Al, this is not good.
That about sums it up.
Oh, I am never drinking again.
I need to talk to Weaver. She's the one in the song, the Lady of the Light.
What, the crazy lady? Ugh, whatever you say, Al, but we're stuck here. They're not gonna...
I had some reading to do first, Sheriff. And let me tell you, it was an interesting read. Well,
I've got you now, Raymond Chandler. It's all here. All the evidence, including conspiracy to murder a federal agent. There's no way you're walking out of here. You hear me in there, Brett Easton Ellis? Huh?
Agent Nightingale, I want to talk to your superior.
Well, we all want things, Sheriff. I wanted my... Look, that's not possible right now.
Can y'all shut up?
Agent Nightingale, please. I insist. Wake, what's wrong?
Lady, are you stupid? It's a trick. It's an obvious trick.
Okay, I've had enough of this crap. Wake, I'm gonna trust you with this.
You're joking.
Agent Nightingale, your opinion would matter more if you were sober and if I actually believed you were here on official business.
Whoa! Get back in the cell, Stephen King. The only way you're leaving this place is over my dead...
Wait a minute. I know this...
Oh my God!
Light. We need light. It's the only way to fight this thing.
In my office. I've got your things there. Follow me.
Oh, man.
All right, y'all.
We're sitting ducks with the lights out.
You guys are enjoying my play.
Stay cool. I can get the emergency power.
When we come back, we will jump into chapter 5, The Clicker. If you are enjoying my playthrough, please hit that like button and subscribe. And as always, peace.